Good afternoon, everyone. Please have a seat. It's an honor to be here for the inaugural President's Cup Cybersecurity Competition Award presentation. I want to thank Vice President Pence for having us here today to celebrate what is the first of what I'm sure will be a very successful competition for years to come. I'd also like to thank my counterparts and colleagues from across the interagency for joining us to recognize the outstanding achievements of these cyber experts. It's no secret that we are living in an era of rapid technological change. Our society, industry, and government have come to rely on new technologies to improve our lives. But these new and emerging technologies certainly present significant risk, either through unintentional impacts or use by our adversaries. In other words, new technologies can be used for good as well as for nefarious purposes. At incredible speed and scale, digital invaders are scanning for weak links on the internet. This means that every organization, no matter the size, and every device connected to the internet is vulnerable to hackers, botnets, and malicious hackers. In this environment, it is critical to have personnel that can secure, defend, and protect the Department of Defense and federal networks and systems. As a result, the U.S. government has made it a priority to recruit talent and build a skilled and seasoned cyber workforce. The engine of our government's cyber defense is housed at DHS's very own Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Security Agency, which protects the .gov network, ensures election security, and works with interagency and private sector partners to identify and manage risk. I want to thank Director Krebs and his team for their outstanding leadership of CISA. CISA also has the privilege of hosting, on behalf of the White House, the competition we're gathered here to celebrate today, and that's the President's Cup for Cyber Competition. The competition is an effort to create a challenging, distinct, and rewarding event for our participants. These challenges replicate the scale, severity, and complexity of cybersecurity threats experts view as posing an existential risk to our country. This year's competition was a resounding success from the start, and I encourage all of you to take a look at some of the videos from the competition that's posted on the CISA media channel on YouTube. After three rounds, one team and one individual rose to the top of the talent pool, proving themselves to be some of the finest cybersecurity experts in the country. Congratulations to our individual winner, Cadet Sears Schultz, and congratulations to our winning team, which include Major Joseph Rukowski, Chief Warrant Officer Philip Smith, Chief Warrant Officer Benjamin Coots, Sergeant First Class Zachary McElroy, and Staff Sergeant Matthew Kondari. To all the participants and teams, thank you for lending your tremendous talent to this competition. Your efforts have set the stage for an incredibly successful competition for the years to come. It's now my honor to introduce the Vice President of the United States, who has been vocal on the cybersecurity threat posed by adversaries such as China, Russia, and others. Sir, your bold leadership on this issue has helped elevate cybersecurity to the national spotlight where it certainly belongs. Ladies and gentlemen, Vice President of the United States.
Well, let me thank and join me in thanking Acting Secretary, Homeland Security Secretary Chad Wall for those wonderful comments. Great comments. Thank you, Mr. Secretary, for your leadership. Thank you for your enthusiasm for this effort. And to you and to Assistant Director Bob Kolaski, to General Joseph Martin, to General Jay Silveri, General Walter Pyatt, General Bradford Schwedo, General Dennis Kroll, to so many great Americans in uniform from around the country, to public servants and family members, let me say on behalf of the First Family, welcome to the White House. It is an honor to be able to welcome you here for the first annual award ceremony for the President's Cup Cybersecurity Competition. It's a big day. And that's a long list of very distinguished Americans and great leaders, and we're honored to have you all here and to really be able to celebrate the accomplishments of some remarkable Americans and everyone who participated in this competition. As you just heard from the Secretary, the Department of Homeland Security worked with departments and agencies from the Pentagon to the FBI to the Department of Energy and the White House to develop a rigorous process to test the skills of the federal cybersecurity workforce. And today represents the first culmination of that competition. The challenges, I'm told, cover topics like data analysis, reverse engineering, cyber defense, secure programming, network operations, and lots of other things that I'll never completely understand, but represent absolutely vital elements of our ability to protect the security and the privacy of the American people. I am told, Mr. Secretary, that more than 1,000 federal employees and 200 teams took part in this competition. And after two rounds, the department narrowed the final competition down to 5 teams, 10 individuals, including those that we will honor today. Each of today's award winners will receive an engraved glass bowl, and more importantly, each one of you will have the gratitude of your Commander-in-Chief, the President of the United States. And so allow me to bring greetings and congratulations on behalf of President Donald Trump to each and every one of you. Well done. Our first award goes to a remarkable team of officers and enlisted soldiers in the United States Army. Members of the team work in different agencies, even in different parts of the country. They'd gotten to know each other over the years in previous assignments, I'm told, and when the competition was announced, they got back in contact and formed this team. They acted entirely on their own initiative, and it's amazing to think that it was all in their spare time. And now to receive the award on behalf of the team, their senior officer, a proud graduate of West Point, a 17-year veteran stationed at Fort Smith, Georgia. Join me in congratulating the leader of this team, Major Josh Rakowski. Congratulations, Josh. Congratulations.
Thank you. Put on the spot here real quick, but I just wanted to, you know, anytime I get a chance to work with these individuals over here, it's a fantastic day because, again, you know, anytime I walk in the room and I'm not the smartest person there, it's a great day because I'm always learning. So these guys all have something to share with me. We come from a broad background, you know, officer, two warrant officers, and two NCOs. So again, you know, it's not just, you know, one person in the fight, it's everybody. And so, you know, and the fact that we all grew up on the defensive side, you know, gave us a breadth of knowledge that allowed us to really tackle a lot of the problems and get after a lot of the issues that we were looking at in the competition. So again, we appreciate all the effort that went into putting the competition together, and appreciate everyone on the team's effort in attacking it and getting after it. So thank you very much.
Go Army. Really great job. And this one's from another branch of our armed forces, but I know they're just as proud. In fact, just last week I visited Peterson Air Force Base in the shadow of the Air Force Academy. And today I'm proud to be here to present the President's Cup Award to a member of the 26th Squadron at the Air Force Academy. We're also honored to be joined by members of his family, his dad, who's a retired Army Colonel, Martin Schultz, his mom, Kristen Schultz, where are you? Where are the family members here? I know how proud you are. I really do. And while I'm told he had to beat out more than 1,000 federal employees to win this competition, he actually hadn't even begun his military career yet. So we're incredibly excited about what this great young American is going to mean to our armed forces and to the future of this country. So with that, it is with great pride that I present the first ever President's Cup Individual Award to Air Force Cadet First Class Sear Schultz.
I just had a great time to this competition. I just really enjoy what I do with cybersecurity. I want to thank General Saveria, my academy superintendent, for coming along. and supporting me through these competitions I do at school. I thank my parents, Martin and Kristen, for coming and supporting me as I get to do stuff I love and continue to do it throughout the Air Force. Thank you.
Great. Well, General Saveri, he mentioned you, so let me just say on behalf of the Commander-in-Chief, I know this award is also a tribute not just to Cadet Schultz, but to the entire Air Force Academy and the incredible Americans that you train there every day. So thank you for your leadership and your service. And the fact that both of these awards, which were government-wide, remember that. This was people from all over every branch of government. The fact that both of these awards, the team award and the individual award, this year have gone to those who are serving in the uniform of the United States simply confirms what the President and I know and every American knows, that the United States has the greatest military the world has ever known, and they've proven it again today. I mean, the truth is, these men standing behind me obviously have the ability they could, in this modern economy, do anything that they wanted to do. But they're aspiring to wear the uniform, and they're wearing the uniform of the United States. And so let me just say, on behalf of a grateful nation and your Commander-in-Chief, thank you for your service, and congratulations to each and every one of you. With that, we're going to take a few pictures and shake a few hands with family members. I know the family members and friends who are here and senior officers who are here are very proud of this moment. But let me close by saying once again, when President Trump established the President's Cup cybersecurity competition, it's all about making our nation more secure, making sure that our government can not only protect this nation, but protect the privacy of the American people. This year's competition proves out not just that we have winners, but literally thousands and thousands of Americans have participated in this competition. Each and every one of them deserve our thanks for their service, for making this an extraordinarily successful first installment of the President's Cup cybersecurity competition. And I know that as the years go on, we'll continue to see more winners. But join me in thanking all of the winners who participated in this competition this year. They're making a difference for America. Thank you.